I've concerns about the bill. I've concerns, and yet I can see that it's not right for families to be separated. And I think that local authorities are taking a particular view sometimes that the 88 Act and that section of the 88 Act was for a cohort of people who had other complex needs. But the basic fact of it is that no child should be homeless, and it's not acceptable for us to consider that any child would be homeless. And I don't want children to be labelled as homeless. I think the normalisation, some of the things that we've heard in the last week or two, the normalisation of homelessness, making comparisons to other countries, trying to minimise the extent of the crisis that we have, is a backdrop to the debate tonight, unfortunately. And the minute we accept family hubs as a replacement, for example, to homes, the minute we accept child homelessness, then we start dealing with it differently, and I have major concerns from that point of view. When we have a Taoiseach who, forcibly defended his comments about things are not that bad, while over 3,000 children will spend Christmas in emergency accommodation, and he's been supported by the chair of the National Housing Agency in some of the views. I think we've got to say that we're not dealing with reality, we're dealing with propaganda here. That propaganda is really having a very detrimental impact on people who are suffering at this very point in time. Children are worrying about things that children shouldn't have to worry about. Surely the best interest for children is provided by looking at the constitutional rights in a very real way, and the very real way is by either challenging the constitution if it doesn't allow the flexibility to use things like, for example, compulsory purchase orders and the extent of the rents that can be charged. I've got to say that I'm really feel that. Not particularly talking about this bill, but I do think that listening to the list of things, I heard the minister on one of the primetime programmes there in the last week, listing all of the things that he was doing just to stand still or go backwards. And at some point, we've got to say that, like the children's fairy tale about the emperor has no clothes, is very much one that's coming to mind.